An SDK, which stands for Software Development Kit, is, as its name suggests, a set of software tools intended for developers to facilitate either the development of applications or the development of features for existing applications, all on a target platform. Each SDK is different and may include more or fewer tools with it. You can typically find documentation, serving as a user manual for the SDK, a compiler, which translates human-readable source code into machine-readable binary code, a linker, which links modules and libraries into an executable file, code libraries, in other words, code already written by other developers that can be reused, for example, code snippets, classes, pre-compiled code, etc. Graphic elements such as buttons, icons, images, etc. Some SDKs also include integrated development environments, or IDEs, like Eclipse or Visual Studio. These are essentially development environments where the developer can write code with many advanced features to simplify their work. The IDE allows code editing, compilation, and debugging. Finally, the SDK facilitates the use of APIs, enabling external communication with a third-party application, providing a service, so that the developer doesn't need to redevelop a service that already exists. If the concept of APIs is not very clear to you, I strongly encourage you to watch my dedicated video on the subject on my channel. A software development kit is provided by an organization to assist developers in creating applications on their platform. For instance, the iOS Mobile SDK provides various tools for creating applications for iPhones, while the Android SDK allows development for Android applications. Thus, for the Google Maps application, we will have two different SDKs, one for Android development and the other for iOS. The content of an SDK will vary depending on the organization providing it for their platform. One of the key benefits of using SDKs is the acceleration of the application development, allowing the developers to focus on creating valuable features. Moreover, when organizations release SDKs to the public, they encourage a community of developers to contribute and enhance the platform, creating an ecosystem of third-party plugins, extensions, and integrations that expand the capabilities of the original software. For instance, the Android ecosystem boasts a wide range of third-party SDKs and libraries that have enriched the Android app development landscape. Finally, SDKs allow consistency and compatibility across different applications. They ensure that developers adhere to best practices and design standards specific to the platform, resulting in a seamless user experience. We've reached the end of this video. I hope it was informative and enjoyable. If you want to keep up with the latest in tech and computer science, don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications. I can't wait to delve into more tech topics with you in our future videos. Goodbye.